use that projective resolution would lead nowhere. There are many reasons for that. Projective resolution would lead nowhere. But what about injective resolution? But injective resolution, you need to build a certain class of sheaves called injective sheaves, with a certain property. It doesn't matter. Well, Kotelnik did not try that. He said, I take not a given space, I take the category of all sheaves, what he called a topos after that. And he still considers that it's one of his major discoveries. You replace the space by the category of all sheaves, and you express everything in terms of the category of sheaves. Okay, now, next question. If you want to have an injective sheaves and injective evolution, what kind of general property should the category of sheaves satisfy? Then he develops this in his big paper, so-called Torku paper. He develops this at length. He comes with some condition called AB5 star, for whatever reason, AB5 star, because he has AB1, AB2, AB5, and then the covariant, which is AB5. And then he said, okay, assuming these very, very general properties of a category, I can do everything. Now, end of the proof, I take the specific category of sheaves, and this AB5 star condition is very easy to check. No. So we have been many people to struggle with many particular cases, trying to extend it. He killed everything overnight. So, and this has been, I have enough now. I will just finish in a few minutes. And then what he had, he repeated this strategy many times. And then every time he always invented the most abstract notion, and knew how to use it. Of course, this has its limits. This method has its limitations.